Hi, welcome to Dental School. Today I'm going to discuss with you objectives of impression making in complete denture. It's an extract from Prosthodontics. So let's start. Definition: impression is a negative likeness or copy in reverse of the surface of an object, an imprint of the teeth and adjacent structures for use in dentistry. So here in complete denture, we are referring to the copy of edentulous arch, and we use impression compound, okay? We use impression compound to record the impression, okay? Coming to the objectives. So I have used the mnemonic PRESS, okay? Let's see what PRESS stands for. So starting with P for preservation of supporting or residual structures. R for retention, E for aesthetics, S for stability, and yet another S for support. Okay, remember this mnemonic PRESS. So before discussing these objectives, I would like to give you a clear-cut idea about the difference between the retention, stability and support by means of the vector of forces. Vector of forces as in the direction of force, okay? Okay, so there is always force which is acting on the denture. I am giving you pictorial representations or animations so that you people will remember, okay? So there are forces like vertical forces and horizontal forces which is acting on the denture. So vertical forces can act towards the tissue or away from the tissue. For example, gravity or adhesiveness of food, that is sticky food. So the forces can be towards the tissue or away from the tissue when it is vertical, and there is also horizontal type of forces. So imagine that yellow box is your tissue onto which your denture base is adapted. Then the force acting away from the tissue is resisted by some kind of quality of this denture which we make, that is retention. Okay, so retention acts against the forces which is directed away from the tissue. About the support, it acts against the forces which is in the direction towards the tissue. Okay, remember the color, red color, retention, away from the tissue. Support, green color, okay, green shows support towards the tissue. Now there is stability, that is resistance against those horizontal forces, okay. I'm just giving you the idea, these are not the ideal definitions, I'm giving you the idea, okay. Now let's start with the objectives. Preservation of supporting structures. Okay. So preservation of remaining oral structure is important to long-term success of the denture. Accurate impression is what we need, and that we acquire through selective impression technique. So what is selective impression technique? It is one of the three impression techniques here. So the pressure is applied selectively on the stress bearing areas and it is reduced from the relief area. Okay. So we do this by framing a custom tray. Okay. So the pressure is on the stress bearing area and it is reduced from the relief area. So this is important for the preservation. Now coming to retention. Definition: that quality inherent in the dental prosthesis acting to resist the forces of dislodgement along the path of placement. I've already explained to you what retention is. Now this is the definition. It is related to forces that resist the forces of gravity, adhesiveness of food and opening of jaws. Okay. Now coming to the factors affecting retention, you can remember this either by using code, that is maybe MAP PM or MP MAP, anything, but I don't think you need a mnemonic for this. So let's start. with our basic first year subject, okay, that is anatomy. So starting with anatomical factors. Size of the denture bearing area. So the size of the denture bearing area is proportional to retention. More the size, more the retention. So we need to make the denture base area more. Okay, average size of the maxillary denture base area is 24 centimeter square and average size of mandibular denture base area is 14 centimeter square. You need to remember that, very important one. Now the second part is tissue displaceability. So if we take an impression, automatically what happens, the tissue will get displaced. So we need to apply adequate pressure, or else what happens, once we remove this impression, the tissue will rebound. So after framing the denture base or the denture, when we insert it, again this rebound factor comes. So there will be loss of retention. Now coming to the second one, second subject in our first year, physiological factors. The amount of saliva. Saliva plays a major role in the retention of the denture. Okay. So saliva, if it is thin and watery, will get good retention. Thick and ropey, there will be loss of retention. And in case of xerostomia or absence of saliva, there will be irritation and soreness of the tissues. Now coming to the physical factors. We did anatomical and physiological factors. Now coming to the physical factors, okay? So there is adhesion, cohesion, interfacial surface tension, capillarity, atmospheric pressure and gravity. So I'll make this easier for you to remember. Let's start with adhesion. Imagine that brown and blue line, in between them it is the denture base, between the two blue lines it is saliva, and between the violet and the green line it is the mucosa. Okay, so you can see the red arrows which shows the interaction of molecules in between these three. So in denture base there will be acrylic resin, in saliva there is salivary glycoproteins, and in mucosa there is surface epithelium. So different types of molecules, that is different types of molecules or unlike molecules, are having a physical attraction. That is called as adhesion. Okay. Now let us see cohesion. Same figure, same parts, except the fact that there will be a small attraction between the molecules within the saliva. So physical attraction of like molecules. Adhesion is the physical attraction of unlike molecules to one another, and cohesion is the attraction of like molecules to one another. Okay, remember that. Now adhesion depends on close adaptation of denture, size of denture bearing area, type of saliva, and cohesion depends on consistency and viscosity of the saliva. Okay. Okay. Now coming to the next part, that is interfacial surface tension. Imagine the green line represents the glass plate. So there are two glass plates and the blue area, it shows the water. So what is interfacial surface tension? Okay. We need to know that when there is water in between two solids, it tends to form a tension, which is formed as due to the resistance to this separation. Okay, that liquid, it gives a tension or resistance to this separation. Okay, that is what is called as interfacial surface tension. For that we have a formula called Stephen's formula, which is F is equal to, F here is surface tension or the force, so F is equal to 4.7 into K. K is the viscosity of the liquid which is in between, R raised to 4. R is the radius of the surfaces, those solid surfaces, divided by H raised to 3. H is the distance between the surfaces and V is the velocity of force into V. Okay. So here, greater the space, that is if H is the distance between the two surfaces. Okay. Greater the space, this force will be less. So what do we understand? We need to adapt the denture more close. More close, so there will be less space. So what happens? The surface tension will increase and thus retention will increase. And greater the radius, that is greater the area covered by the denture, greater will be the surface tension or interfacial surface tension, and greater will be the retention. Okay, so remember this formula. Interfacial surface tension, it is defined as the tension or resistance to separation possessed by a film of liquid between two well-adapted parallel surfaces. Wettability of fluid is inversely proportional to the surface tension of the surfaces. Now coming to the next part, that is capillarity. That quality or state which because of surface tension causes elevation or depression of the surface of a liquid that is in contact with the solid. That is, for example, imagine we are dipping a paintbrush into water. You can see all the bristles will come closer and will form a bunch. That is what is capillarity. That is when we bring close a solid in contact with a liquid, then either the liquid will get elevated or it will get depressed. So capillarity, if there is a thin film of saliva, it will cause the saliva to rise and thus there will be more contact between the denture base and the mucosa, which means what? There will be more retention. Okay. Next is atmospheric pressure. When a force is exerted perpendicular to or away from the basal seat of denture, which is properly extended and fully seated, pressure between prosthesis and mucosa drops below ambient pressure. This is called as suction. That is what we totally require when we take what a secondary impression. Okay. So how does this suction form? Just see the figure. That red color area, that is our mucosa, blue colored is our saliva, and that pink color is our denture base bearing the tooth. So when this denture base, it is adapted very close with an effective peripheral border seal and everything, then what happens? There will be a difference between the pressure that is the atmospheric pressure and the pressure inside this or in the salivary film. So that causes a void where pressure drops. Okay. So this will cause suction or the resistance. Okay. Now coming to the last one, that is gravity. Gravity is a natural force and it aids in retention of mandible, especially when there is more weight and other retentive forces and factors are marginal. So in case of mandible, it helps in retention, whereas in maxilla, it is not helping in the retention. Okay. Now coming to the mechanical factors, we told about anatomical, physiological, physical. Now coming to the mechanical factors. First one is undercuts. Moderate undercut enhances retention due to underlying mucosa. But severe undercut, if there is severe undercut, it will compromise retention. So we need to surgically eliminate those undercuts. Then there is denture adhesives. So we use these powder form adhesives for helping the people who are having poor ridges, etc., so that their denture will stay with more retention in the mouth. So we use these denture adhesives. It enhances retention by increasing adhesive and cohesive property by eliminating voids between denture base and basal seat tissues. Then there is suction chambers and discs. So they create a negative pressure in the palatal surface of maxillary denture, and that enhances the retention, but they're avoided, okay? They cause papillary hypoplasia. So the first figure, it shows a suction disc, and second figure, it shows a commercially available denture adhesive powder. Now coming to the fifth part, that is muscular factors. Oral and facial musculature and tongue supply supplementary retentive forces. So teeth must be positioned in the neutral zone. What is neutral zone? It is the area between the cheek and the tongue. Then the polished surfaces of the dentures should be contoured, and denture base must cover maximum area, and the occlusal plane must be in correct level. Okay. Coming to the next objective, that is stability. The quality of a removable dental prosthesis to be firm, steady, or constant. Okay, FSC. Firm, steady, or constant to resist displacement by functional, horizontal, or rotational stresses. Factors affecting stability. Vertical height of residual ridge. Stability is directly proportional to vertical height of residual ridge. So here we can see there is a high ridge. In figure B there is intermediate, and figure C there is low ridge. So when the ridge is high, that is vertical height is good, it will contribute to better stability, okay, due to decreased leverage. Now coming second one, that is quality of soft tissue covering the ridge. Flabby ridges, if there are flabby ridges, it will cause poor stability. Adaptation of denture to the tissue. Accurate impression gives proper adaptation, which gives stability. Next is occlusal plane. Occlusal plane should be parallel to the ridges and divide inter-arch equally. Inclined occlusion planes will cause sliding forces and cause instability. Okay, so here the B, line B shows occlusal plane, and A shows the inter-arch space. So this inter-arch space must be equally divided. Teeth arrangement. Teeth should be in balanced occlusion and in neutral zone. Contour of polished surface. It should be in harmony with the functioning of oral muscles to promote stability. Now, support. The last objective, that is definition, the resistance to vertical forces of mastication, occlusal forces, and other forces applied in the direction towards the basal seat tissues. I've already explained this. Important thing coming in support, that is snowshoe effect. To provide adequate support, the denture base should cover as much denture bearing area as possible. This distributes force over a large area and is known as snowshoe effect. So denture base, here the denture base is covering maximum area, so we can see the forces are distributed evenly in the large area. Okay, coming to the question bank, essays, define impression, which you know, stick on to the GPT 8 definition. Then discuss in detail objectives of complete denture. You need to remember our mnemonic. What was it? PRESS. P for preservation of residual structures, R for retention, E for aesthetics, S for stability, and S for support. Then you write in detail. Don't forget to write all the titles. For example, write retention, then you write the definition, factors affecting, name all the factors and whatever comes in it. At least you need to mention those names, figures, and try to remember the definitions. Then define stability of complete denture and factors affecting stability. While writing factors affecting stability for that vertical height of residual ridge, don't forget to draw the figure which I showed in the slide. And again for the occlusal plane, again you can draw that figure. Okay. Then what is retention and factors affecting retention? You need to explain with figures. Okay. Then short notes, neutral zone. I told you neutral zone is the zone between cheek and the tongue. Then you need to write that you need to position the teeth in this neutral zone. It aids in stability. For teeth arrangement, we require to follow this neutral zone. Again, in retention, in the muscular factors, we again say musculature, facial musculature and tongue. It aids for retention. So again, you need to write about neutral zone. Mention all that when neutral zone is asked. Role of saliva in complete denture. Write about saliva's role starting from where? Physiological factor in retention. Then we have adhesion, cohesion, interfacial surface tension, capillarity. All these depends on what? Saliva. Okay. Saliva is very important. Try to draw a figure. Even if it is a short note, when you don't have time, try to draw the figures. Reference, I've referred textbook of Prosthodontics, V. Rangarajan. Now you go back to your textbooks. Please read this. And if you have any doubts, you can feel free to comment below in the comment box or directly mail us in dentalschoolfor@gmail.com. Or if you want any topics to be discussed further in our coming videos, please do mention in the comment box below. Okay, and if you found this video useful, please do like, subscribe, and don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thank you.